tell us about the engineer that you got on Heart Condition, because I remember you telling me about this engineer who basically was either nominated for Grammy or had won a Grammy or something for, like a Baton Rouge well-known kind of engineer.
Yeah, man, his name's Devin Kirkpatrick, man. He's an engineer in Baton Rouge. He's got his own studio. He's had it since 99. He's a 12-time Grammy nominee, 5-time Grammy winning engineer. He was actually, I don't know if you remember, there was a Backstreet Boys album that sold 12 million, I think it was called Millennial. And he worked for Sony at the time, and he was the lead engineer on that. So that's one of the credits that he has. But if you go look up his name, Devin Kirkpatrick, then you'll see all the artists that he's worked with. And he's worked with some secular, and he's worked with some Christian artists, like the Williams Brothers and Kirk Franklin. And so, yeah, man, it's awesome to be in there with him. He's the type of engineer, I can just go in and do my part. If it takes me about 2 hours to lay all my stuff down, then I sit behind him while he mixes for however long it takes him to finish. And when it's said and done, man, he gives me a week to listen to my music. And if I think it's ready to go, then he masters it and we put it out. It's a beautiful system, man. It's always nice to have somebody that has that skill level in what they do.
Probably quite cool, because obviously inside of your own area that you live, if you have this one talented engineer that you can work with, and obviously he knows you and he feels comfortable working with you, that's an amazing thing to add to your kind of your hookup, isn't it?
Yeah, man, it's all God, bro. You know, only God can orchestrate things that way. When I first recorded Make It Rain, I was still kind of dealing with some street cats, and that didn't work out. And I was praying. I said, God, what do I do? You know, I want to put this music out. You put it on my heart. You provided provisions, and he brought it up to my remembrance that I knew Devin, and that I had went to Devin's studio in the past, and he told me to make the phone call, and I did, and we went in there, and we recorded the other three tracks for Walking in Faith, and then with this project, I recorded everything there, and man, it's so in and out, bro. I go in, this one I did a six-hour session, and it only took us about 4 hours and 45 minutes to get everything done. And so we just go in and knock it out and go home, bro. And it's beautiful, man. Like I said before, it's so nice to be in there with somebody, because, you know, he'll ask me, hey, do you think I should do this or whatever? And my answer to him is, hey, man, you do this for a living, bro. You do what you think you should do. And if I don't like it, I'll tell you. If I don't say nothing, then we're good. And yet, so far on 7 songs, I haven't had to tell him anything. So it's a blessing, man.
Yeah, man, that's really good, man. So are you planning to do any videos for this one?
I'm praying for provisions, man. On my last album, I had a song called No Matter What. I'm sure you know that song. I want to do a visual for that one as soon as I get the funds. And I have a couple on this one that I'd like to. I think the route that I'm going to take is saving up some money and buying a camera and starting to shoot my own stuff. Nothing against the guys that do that, but God's been pouring out on me. I know you've seen me. I've been working on making album covers, and I've been working on making flyers and lyric videos and stuff, and I feel like as he's pouring those things out on me that he's going to give me the knowledge and understanding to be able to make my own videos. So that's the route I think I'm going to take. Obviously, like we just stated earlier, if he moves differently, then I'm going to go the way that he moves. But right now, that's what I'm looking at.
Yeah, man, it may as well, man. It's always good to do your own thing, and you know, at least then you have more creative control. And you know, I mean, you should have creative control in order, but you know what I'm saying, it's good to be able to handle everything yourself in some ways, and then you can just mold and shape it exactly how you want it, can't you?
Right. And I'm the type of cat, man, with all the stuff that I've been doing recently, man, I'll do the work, and I'll tell you if God puts it on your heart to bless me with something. So I'm not going to name the brother's name, but I made a flyer for him. I wasn't expecting anything, and he blessed me with $50. And so I think with all my skills, I'm going to start doing them like that, even with my music. If you want a feature from me, I'll lay the feature down. And the thing is this, man, because I would do it for free anyways, right? So if I let you and God have that conversation about what I need at that point in time, then I can't go wrong. So moving into, if I do get a camera and start shooting videos, I think I'm going to do it the same way. A lot of cats have set prices. I have no problem with that, bro. But I feel like if I enjoy the song and I would shoot the video for free, then I'm going to do it that way, and I'm going to do my best work. And when you get the video back, If God moves and he allows you to bless me with something, then that's fine. If not, that's fine as well. You know, I'm just trying to implement those things, man. You know, there may be a time and a place where he moves and gives me a set price. But I think starting out with all this stuff, that's the way I'm going to handle it.
Yeah, man, I really like that, man. That's a really good heart, man, to do that. And it takes a lot to do that because, you know, something I battle with as well. You're thinking like, well, because the thing is, you know, the kind of work that you're going to put into something and you feel like, well, you know, if I'm going to do a set piece of work for this amount, I know how much work and for example, I've got a good work ethic. I know how much hard work I'm going to put into it. And it kind of is like, well, you could leave at the end and say, well, you know, give donation or something and somebody either gives you nothing or barely nothing. It kind of like, that's what goes in your head, right. You see. You don't know what they're going to give, but it goes in your head like, you know, what if that happens? You know, it makes you feel like, you know, worthless or what is the point of that, you know what I mean? But
I mean, surely if you're doing work that everybody makes $400 or $500 off of and somebody gives you $10 or $20, you're going to be frustrated. But then again, you might do the next one expecting the same thing to happen and God might move. They might give you $1,200.
Exactly,
they
man.
Might have it and their heart might be there. So, you know, you just got to hang on and know that he's in control of all those things.
Exactly, man. You got to hold on because, like, you don't know. Because you're putting these what-ifs in your brain and you don't know what's going to happen at the end of the day. God can use people to bless your circumstance. It's a good heart, man, to be able to say, like, you know, I'm just going to do it and see what happens. You know what I mean? Because at the end of the day, the other thing also, if you're starting out with something, you don't know how good the quality is of what you're doing. You might think, oh, it's standard, but it might not be, or it might be, you know? So you let someone just bless you as they will, which is kind of a good way to do it at the beginning.
Yeah, I think so. I mean, like I said, if he moves and gives me set prices, my skill set goes up and it's worth it. And, you know, that's the thing is you look at all these guys that have set prices, but you don't know if they started out like that. So that's why it's very important not to judge somebody because they may have started out only charging $50 and now they're up to a skill level where they can charge $500. And so you can't really come against them about that. You know what I'm saying?
Definitely, man. All right, man. Well, I really pray that heart condition does go well for you, man, because I think your whole mission statement so far and everything you've been through, man, it's just worked out. I would say it's worked out so wonderful, but it's been because you've been blessed by God, but that's been because you've been obedient, you know what I mean? And it's been showing in your story so far, man. I mean, from your backstory of what we heard last time, of where you've come from to where you are now, like all the problems you had with drugs and drink and your life was in a mess, and now to be in the position where you're being able to be used by God and God is blessing you with the means to do all these things and make music and on a consistent basis. It's absolutely amazing to hear, and I really pray that it continues, man. And I really believe it will continue as long as you stay obedient to his word and to what he wants. And I just applaud you, man, for everything you've done up until this point, man. It's really, really good work.
Thank you. That means a lot coming from you, and really.
All right, man. So where can people go grab you, man? And obviously for the EP itself, when it comes out next week, where can people go grab that?
All right. Well, the EP right now is Heart Condition. It's on pre-order on Amazon and iTunes for sure. But if you don't have the money, I understand that. If you go to my website, www.bdkold.com, I've got all the tracks that I've ever made up there. There's a site-wide player, and all 8 of the tracks are up there. Also, when it comes out, man, it'll be on YouTube, it'll be on Spotify, it'll be on all those streaming services. So if you don't have the funds to go get it or you don't feel led to buy it, that's fine, man. At least listen to it, give me some plays, enjoy it. Man, hit me up and tell me what songs you like, tell me the ones you don't like, and let me know why you don't like them so that I can pray about that and begin to move in those areas and try to do some things a little bit better. But, yeah, Facebook is www.facebook.com//BDKOLD, and the website is www.BDKOLD.com.